afternoon, and thanks for listening. As you know, I'm Lee, and this is Riley, and we're talking about Project Nexus. Just quickly, as a recap, there are a few problems in Troy that led us to starting this project. First of all, there are many small disengaged groups, such as the neighborhood groups, the government, and various other bodies in Troy. Second, there is disengaged, uninvolved citizenry. In general, the election turnout is fairly low, and people have rather low morale when it comes to actually making positive change in their city. Third, so far there's been no successful centralized effort to correct these problems or to make an effort for citizens to change their community in a positive way. And fourth, this isn't just a problem that is, it doesn't just affect Troy. This affects RPI, this affects other cities, and pretty much any body where there are different organizations trying to improve the area, you have this issue. So it's something that goes far beyond just us here. All right, these are some pictures of the Business Improvement District in Troy and their leader, Elizabeth Young, up there. We've been collaborating very closely with the Business Improvement District. I've been in constant email communication with Elizabeth Young about this project. We've also been working with a lot of other groups, different politicians and prospective politicians. The elections are coming up in this November, so they're all very excited about this. Different neighborhood groups, Troy Neighborhood Action Council. And I think that it's very important that we continue to work with this community on these, on developing the project. Half of the project success will be, I mean, part of it is design, but the other part is implementation, getting it to be accepted by the groups we hope to use it. So we're working very closely with the neighborhood groups on... on developing their needs and making sure that they're excited and know that this product is coming. So we're, as I said, we're interfacing with stakeholders, doing a lot of meetings, meetings with the mayoral candidates, with the different candidates for city council, with the leaders in the neighborhood associations and in the other community groups in Troy. We've been collecting feedback about what they think is important. So far, we have most of the needs covered, but they've, from these meetings, they've really highlighted, you know, people in Troy don't necessarily really get technology or social networking. We need to make it easy to use. We need to make it accessible to all people. And we've been establishing what our priorities are. So you've seen this before. This is our mind map, and basically this is what we based the actual implementation of the project on. Here we talk about the different users who will be using our project, our expected, their expected needs and priorities, the different the user interface for the website, the functionality we need, the different projects we'll be using, and much more. So this has been a good guide in determining how we'll proceed.
And the mind map had basically a one-to-one mapping to an object diagram. This was one of our early object diagrams. I kind of made sub-object diagrams for each of the things that I was interested in. This is more of an overview of, I guess, how things are sort of laid out. It has a progression across the top from seed to root to sprout, which I'll talk about in a little bit. And a lot of the little things that help link the projects together. Since we're doing Rails, we don't really have very many functions, so the bottom parts of most of the object blocks don't really have much data. It's mostly the variables that we're using. And this sort of translates into the database schema as well, which is the definition of all the different tables we're using and the columns in each table. All right, so I guess I'm going to talk about the three main goals that we're working with Nexus. Project organization is our main goal. Project actualization is, I guess, what will make Nexus a success. And then finally, some of the community engagement aspects. For project organization, there are a lot of other websites out there that we showed you in our first presentation that accomplish sort of, I have a task, and we need people to work on it, and here's what the task is going to entail. Nexus takes a step back. We're a little bit more idea-oriented, and all ideas start with a seed. And a seed is something that is a little bit more abstract. It doesn't have defined tasks yet. A seed is a problem. It has a scope, and it has a vision, and it has some basic goals for what's going to be accomplished, but nothing specifics. You sort of get an idea of what sort of resources are necessary to solve this problem, whether those resources are labor, or cash, or maybe some specific expertise, or some sort of objects that would help the project come to its success. At the seed state of the project, we're also soliciting feedback through comments and ratings. So I don't want to call it like an exact sort of a Reddit style thing, but you know, projects will be voted up, rated higher, and those projects are more likely to gain more attention from people who are interested in making that project a success. Once the seed is sort of developed, once the base work is there, it moves on to the next stage, which is the root stage. When we're at the root stage, the idea has moved into sort of a project proposal. In the root stage, we're working on hashing out some of the details, like the exact timeline that the whole thing is going to take to you know, get done, the specific tasks that are going to be performed in order to accomplish each goal, I guess some of the expectations from people, and who the main stakeholders are in the project. At this stage, you can also start assigning people to tasks, and I guess sort of subtasks as well, since someone might not be able to accomplish all of the tasks. At this point, we're also trying to get as many people involved as possible. People will be able to share the project with you know, specified groups and organizations, including local governments, neighborhood associations, and even individuals with common interests. The goal here is to get as many resources allocated and pledged for the project as possible. Again, we're still vetting the full thing through comments and ratings, and previous attributes from the seed are carried over in sort of an archive state, so if anyone wants to see how the project has progressed, they can see it there. Once everything in the root stage is done, it's the sprout stage, which is an underway project. Most of the previous information is, you know, sort of designed to be frozen, but it'll be actually, in practice, it'll be, you know, people will be discouraged from editing the older information. Once the project is going, the main idea of the sprout is just a place for the people who are working on the project to share updates. One of the things that, you know, in designing this, I wanted to keep a little bit flexible, and it's not necessary to go through the entire progression. You create a root from a seed, you create a sprout from a root, but you don't necessarily have to have the previous existing object, I guess. This is so that, I guess, if an organization is already working on a project and they weren't using Nexus before, they can immediately create their sprout and start sharing how their project is, sharing how their project is going without having to fill out all arbitrary information previously. So if people have already done the groundwork offline, we'll be able to quickly get them up to speed with Nexus. The final stage isn't really a part of the main project progression, but it's still a very important part of our website. That is the Blossom stage, and this is for completed projects. We figure, and this is mainly Lee's sort of notion, was that people who see successes in completed projects will be more likely to try their own projects, since they kind of gain that sort of confidence that there are people out there with resources who are able to help. And when you get sort of more of a social organization or social networking sort of thing involved, you know, everyone feeds up everyone else's skills and abilities. But seeing what has been done in the past can help people get a little bit more information about you know, what their local government is doing for them, what community organizations have done, how, I guess, things really are progressing, and can help to alienate some of the, or help to get rid of some of the alienation that some people feel with regard to, you know, student governments, or governments. I guess for students especially who have a strong sense of apathy, seeing what could be done at RPI, or what has been done at RPI, could really help to get people more motivated to try their own projects. The last note here is that some projects may be recurring, either seasonal things like maybe snow removal. Again, you don't need to create a whole new seed sprout, seed root sprout. You can just go straight to the sprout and something like that. Community engagement, these are sort of the social networking and user organization management sort of ideas. We're grouping users by two main categories, that is organizations and groups, which are sort of defined. Actually, I guess the terminology is strange. The top one is basically a group, which is, I guess, a defined membership. A group is an object that exists on the site, and depending on the type of the group, people can be invited to the group, or by invitation only, or by you know, anyone who's free to join. The other grouping of people, which isn't really a group, is interest groups, where people define their interests in their user profile, and they're linked together by those interests. And so these would generally manifest themselves in sort of a physical presence, like maybe the government organizations actually meet, the neighborhood associations actually meet, whereas the interest groups are completely, you know, digital, and people are less likely to know each other and actually meet. Finally, government involvement is absolutely key for the success of this project at a civic level, and that's something that Lee has been ensuring is going to work for us. Implementation stuff, we talked about this a little bit before. Rails, Ajax, jQuery, SQLite, moving to MySQL sometime down the line. I guess real quick, little IDE shot. Rails generates tons and tons and tons of files across the left and the top are the controllers and the models and some of the views, and there's usually 4 or 5 views per folder. The Rails server is running the bottom right. It's doing some tagging operations. It's handling an Ajax request for creating a new tag. Next slide is, I'm not sure what to call this. I think this is more of a concept than anything. Sort of idea of what a seat could look like. This is from the live site. I just put a whole bunch of ipsum, a lorem ipsum, into one of the projects. But you get the kind of idea of, I guess, the feel that we're going for, where the seed's basic stats, or basic information is laid out at the top. Problem, vision, and scope. Things are broken down into goals. You have the name of the goal, short description of the goal. The timeline is defined, and the top goal has been assigned to me. The bottom goal hasn't been assigned yet. Categorization, tags, author. There's a lot of things that do that are links, but I can't really differentiate those yet with CSS. So whether or not something is a link is a mystery on this page. Talking about our schedule real quick. This is an exciting slide. Look at that. That's all the stuff we did a long time ago. Here are some of the things that we did and are currently working on. Most of the project's mission and progression is completely done. I just have to work on some of the Blossom type stuff. Well, that's for the archive section, I guess, so I'm not that far behind on that one. Search should be pretty easy to implement using Rails, we'll just throw in a plugin. User and groups is my main focus right now. We've had user authorization and registration since week one, but getting all the interest groups and community organizations working is my current focus. Next, we'll be looking at social networking integration, which is still sort of a bonus feature. Here's some of the things on our shortlist to some of the things on our short list to accomplish. More meetings with stakeholders. Lee, what do we have on our agenda for the next couple weeks?
Next week we're going to be meeting with Business Improvement District in person to show them what we physically have, as well as we're going to be meeting, I've been working on some mock-ups for how to make the user interface something that are easy for people to work with, and we're also going to be meeting with an RPI alumni and graphic designer next week to he's very interested in helping out and making the site look more polished and more complete product. So that's what we're doing in the short term. More longer term, we'll continue to meet with different government officials, different community groups, and so far we've gotten a lot of interest, and hopefully soon we'll be able to start getting some small groups on to start testing.
And that's where we were, where we will be, and where we hope to be, I guess. So any questions at this point?
GitHub repositories, so the authors,
yep.
Generally says that.
I was working on a branch for a bit,
okay.
And then I created some things earlier this week, but they haven't popped up yet, okay. So hopefully it'll refresh itself.
Okay. There are lots of problems with observability, so I don't know where that.
Yeah, it'd be cool if there was like a request or refresh option. Is Ben?
Ben is not feeling well today.
Okay, all right. Okay. Well, I guess I won't talk to him.
Our project hadn't updated in like 5 days, so we submitted a bug report and it got fixed in like 10 minutes.
Yeah.
So you're doing the issue. So in fact, it is Ben has said he's going to do that for the updating of the branch. There are so many other minor things that we should.
Yeah, I went to update a screenshot and it asked you to type in a description for the screenshot. So I did and I hit submit, and then that modified the description of our entire project, which was interesting as well.
So we have to check there are some things we have to do.
Any other questions? Other than me talking about others,
thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you.